Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. In this video, we are going to see how we can use this Allegro ACS712 current sensor that can measure AC or DC current using Arduino. You can get the code for this project by clicking on the link in the description below, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. Using this Allegro ACS712 chip, you can measure AC or DC current. You can measure AC or DC current, that's main important characteristics. And this is the module, and that's a chip. You can buy this as an independent chip, or maybe buy it as this module that is sold on eBay. And it has only 3 pin. It works with 5 volts, so you can connect a 5 volts here, and then it has just an output. So depending on amount of the current on this side, if you look here, the current passes through, and there is a Hall effect sensor, detects the current and converts it to voltage. So proportionally, you get voltage from 66 millivolts per ampere up to 185 millivolts per ampere. So for every ampere that passes through this, you get a voltage here, and you can convert that voltage to a value that you can read it. This way, this can be used as a current sensor. This module is offered in 5, 10, and 30 ampere. This is a 30 ampere version that we are going to use. The width of this module is 30 millimeter, and the length is 31.2 millimeter. The height or depth is determined by this connector with the pins on the other side. It will be 13.2 millimeter. Now let's have a look at the data sheet. This is a low resistance, and that means that if 2.1 kilovolts or 2100 volts passes through, this is isolating your circuit from that voltage that you're measuring. And the rise time that it can respond is 5 microseconds, and the total output error is 1.5% at 25 degrees. That's very important to know. 1.2 milliohm internal conductor resistance. Current passes here, and that resistance here is 1.2 milliohm. So pin 1, 2, 3, and 4, 1, 2 is one pin of the connection, and 3 and 4 is the other pin of the connection. And this is the chip, and this is a pin 1 on this side. So pin 1 and 2 is the one pin, and 3 and 4 is the other pin. So it will be connected and passes through this. As you can see it there, so let me put it accordingly. And then this is a VCC, 5 volts will be connected to this pin. And there is another filter between pin 6 and ground with one nanofarad, so they put also that capacitor here. And for the VCC, 5 volts also, there is 0.1 microfarad capacitor, so that's the chip. So all the capacitors, the two capacitors are here. And then because there is also an LED, a power LED, when you connect it, it will turn on, so they put a resistor for the this LED. There is nothing else on this module. This module is offered in 5, so this is 5 ampere, 20 ampere, or 30 ampere. And the module is number is the same, except the last portion, which is 05B and 05, 20, and this 30. And here are the rating that I mentioned, plus minus 5, plus minus 20, which means it has no polarity in any way you can connect it, because it can measure AC or DC. And here are the sensitivities. I have 185 millivolts per ampere at 5 volts, so this is more sensitive. As the current increases, we get 100 millivolts per ampere, and at 30 ampere, it's 66 millivolts per ampere. And here are the formulas, how it's done, and some characteristics. And I've collected all these information, and based on those, I've written the code, so this can display the current for us. If you need further details of this, I will provide the link for this, and you can download and read it. And here is the wiring. This is the power supply, the positive and negative. Positive enters into the current sensor, and the negative exits. These two goes to the load. because I wanted to test that with 30 ampere. I put thick wire. Still, this is not thick enough for 30 ampere. It should be at least 12 gauge wire, but this is 14 gauge. I put it, and it will be in series with your load. Here's the explanation how you measure the current. Let's say this is a battery or power source, and this is the load. For example, in DC, this is a positive, it's connected to the load, and from this side it comes to the negative, and the circuit is completed. To measure the current, you can put the ammeter either on that side or on this side. Just cut one of the wire and then put it so the current passes through the load and then goes through the ammeter. Ampere meter will measure it. So this is called putting ammeter in series. And then we put this module in series instead of ammeter. This is our meter, so the current goes here and enters. We can put this on the top the same way. So this is how you can put this in series with the load to measure the current. Here we have a VCC. This will be connected to 5 volts, and then ground is this side. I've connected the VCC, which is the red one, to 5 volts, and then the ground, the brown one, is connected here to the ground, and then the middle one, which is out, is connected to analog zero. Let me explain now the code that I've written. We have defined that VN, analog zero, I will connect this to analog zero. The V out, or the out pin of the module, will be connected here. Voltage that you're connecting for power supply is 5 volts. In case it varies, you have to enter it here. And then we have the model. The model is the determining the characteristic. As I mentioned, we have 5 ampere, 20 ampere version, or 30 ampere, and each has different sensitivity. So this is the array, and we are using the model, and I have explained it as a comment here. If you're using 5 ampere version, use 0, just enter here 0, and if you have 20, enter 1, and if you're using 30 ampere, use 2. Because the voltage is divided from the data sheet, this is, we are getting the quiescent output voltage, QOV, as I called it, and 0.5 multiplied by VCC that you entered. And this is a float voltage. This is a variable that used internally. And then inside the setup, we don't do anything except print this text. Initialize the serial monitor with 9600 baud. If you want to see the serial monitor, click on Tools, Monitor, because this is now not connected. So now it's connected, monitor, and make sure that you're setting this accordingly, because if you don't set this properly, you will not be able to read the text. After that, inside the loop, here are some calculations. So this is a formula. We are reading the A0, and then because the input range is 5 volts comparing to 1024 steps, we are dividing this and multiplying by the voltage that you are getting, so we are getting the raw voltage. And then the raw voltage, you are subtracting the quiescent output voltage, this one, the quiescent output voltage that we calculated here, and then plus some error variation offset, so you can experiment with your own module and change this, or maybe just set it 0 until you get the proper value. And then this is the current. The current is calculated voltage divided by sensitivity of the model. The model that you enter, this is coming from this array. So you do not change this array. You do not change anything beyond this point. And then we say absolute value of the current, because if it's positive or negative, depending on the polarity, we say, or in terms of AC, they say if the current is bigger than current limit. I forgot to mention here, I've set a current limit, because if you're working, let's say, with 30 ampere or 10 ampere, sometimes half ampere or 1 ampere will be neglected, or it will not be your interest value, let's say above 1 ampere or 2 or 3 or 5, whatever, so you set that one here. And we are checking if absolute value of the current, if the current is bigger than the current limit, let's say you set it for 1 amp, if when it's bigger one of 1 amp, then we get the current, but on, in the meantime I'm trying also to print the voltage that is coming out of this pen, subtracted from the supply voltage. This is the voltage. You don't need this, it's just for reference purpose, but this is the main one. You get the current and we set it at 2 decimal places and on the screen, and we print the A. If there is, if this is not true, then we just say no current and we wait 500 milliseconds and it continues like that. Here is now the demonstration of this. The power supply to this device is now 3 volts, and in order to reduce the power I'm trying to use a lower voltage, but the current is our concern, so I'm gonna show you. So 3.2 volts and the current is now 0. Let me just change here and make it 5 ampere, and then if I turn this on, here is a serial monitor 4.98, and this is the current that is showing through this device now. Now let me just change it to 10 ampere. Let's go to 6. Now it's 6, so that's the amount. We can compensate for that because here is a 6. I'm just incrementing it with hand. That is 7, 6.85. So you can see that the amount of compensation is, that's 85, that's 150 milliampere difference, because within a 30 ampere that's very minimal, but still we can fix it. And where we can fix that is this. And here, so we can add some voltage in terms of fixing that. So experimenting with different value, I got at 0.12, so that's around 7 ampere, so we are reading. Now let me just increase it to 8, see if we are getting, that's very good, 8, and then pay attention here, that's the current, and this is what the serial monitor shows. This is the current from the sensor. And now let me increment it to 9. So now it's around 40 milliampere difference. Now that's 10 ampere. It's very good. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So at 15 ampere, 14.81. Now still we are getting some deviation, and 43 watts. I'm increasing the voltage. The voltage should not affect it, but around 5 volts. Now let me increase 16. At 16 we are getting almost 300 less. 17, 18, 19, 20. Now it's 20 ampere, so around 400 milliampere. And now let me go for, so 23. So now this is at 23 ampere. Now it's, this is big difference. Now we are reading 21. Let me see. Now the device is very hot because all of the current is passing through this. And this is too hot. This is not made for 30 ampere. The module, the chip is good for that purpose, but the module, the way they designed it, cannot handle it. It was extremely hot. I shut it down now, letting the module to cool down, and then we will continue with from 23 and we'll see if it can handle 30 ampere. You can set the amount of current that we would not look at, let's say less than 1 ampere will be ignored, 1.10. Now it shows no current and it will ignore all those small values. The device has, the module is cooled down. Let me just turn it on with 23 ampere. Now it's very close to 23, still 450 or 500 milliampere. So I'm going now for 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. So 30 ampere, we are reading almost very hot. I just touched it, it's extremely hot. Oh, device become hot, it reads incorrect value, almost 700 milliampere. You see it's correcting itself as soon as it gets cooler, the correction goes and it goes towards 11. So now it's 11 ampere, the device is still a little hot but cooling down. You see when I hold it in my hand the temperature drops, and as you can see it's correcting itself, meaning that this module needs to be cooled down or maybe designed better for the path of current. For that reason it cannot be trusted above. Thank you for watching. This was introduction to Allegro ACS712 current sensor. Please subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos, and also if you have question or comment, please post it in the description below. I try to answer and reply.